Welcome to the broadcast, my friends. Thank you so much for beginning your week with me today. We are going to jump right in. We're going to start with prayer in two different ways. First of all, I'd like to read a quote from the book On Prayer by E.M. Bounds, a short quote that he actually includes from a man named Alexander White. After I read this short quote, I would like to begin with a word of prayer to our Heavenly Father. Listen to this quote now. Alexander White said, "The greatest and the best talent that God gives to any man or woman in this world is the talent of prayer. And the best payment of interest that any man or woman brings back to God when he comes to reckon with him at the end of this world is a life of prayer. And those servants best put their Lord's money to the exchangers who rise early and sit late, as long as they are in this world, ever finding out and ever following after better and better methods of prayer, and ever forming more secret, more steadfast, more spiritually fruitful habits of prayer, until they literally pray without ceasing. And until they continually strike out into new enterprises in prayer and new achievements and new enrichments." I've recommended it to you before, and I will again. You should pick up this book, On Prayer, by E.M. Bounds. Powerful work. I believe just concluded the second chapter of this book. There's so much more that I'm excited to share with you. We'll get into chapter 3 with a short reading tomorrow. But if we can, let's begin with a word of prayer to God. Father, I thank you so much for this great opportunity. Thank you for these faithful listeners. Lord, if you would, for the next few moments, lighten the burden, open the eyes. Please bless these next 10 or 11 minutes together. May the listener right now, may he leave encouraged. May she go into the remainder of this week with your full power and for your glory. We ask all these things in your Son's name we pray. Amen. I'd like to share with you a tract that I have with me in just one moment. But before we do that, I have a letter from the front. It's actually related to our radio broadcast. Here's what Miss Jan says. "Dear Brother Micah, I ran across your radio program the other day. I know it wasn't by accident, because you were sharing a particular tract called I Have Plenty of Time. That's why I'm writing, because I would like about 20 copies of that tract, because there are some teenagers in my neighborhood that are basically left to themselves, and I believe this tract could be a help. I would also like a sample packet of your tracts. Thank the Lord for your ministry, and I pray his continual blessings upon it." Miss Jan, thank you so very much for taking the time to write to us about that. Now, that track, I Have Plenty of Time, of course, you can find it on our website, Bible Tracts, Inc. But I'd like to take a moment and highlight another one of our tracks for just a moment. I don't know if you know this or not, no pun intended, but you can know. That's the title of this tract right here. You can know. The subtitle is Real Answers to Eternal Issues. Did you know that the Bible has the answers? Answers to questions like, where are the dead? Are there spirits alive? What about heaven? What about hell? What will become of me when I die? Did you know that you can know? Did you know that the Bible has the answers to those specific questions? You can find on our website, if you go to our website, BibleTractsInc.org, and you tap on tracts, there's many places on the front page you can find our free tracts. And if you go to our online store, now it's almost funny calling it a store because our tracts, we give them away for free. And we're so proud to be able to do that and equip Christians like yourself with our tracts. But if you go to our online store and search for You Can Know, you can find this particular tract. We'd love to send it to you. You know, the Bible has the answers. And if you're listening right now and you do not claim Christ, you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I am so very glad that you're listening today, because we are starting a brand new study. We are going to be beginning today, this week, and a little bit longer than that. We'll see how long the Lord takes us, but we are going to be beginning a discipleship study. We begin with study number one today. I'd like you to join me for just one moment in the book of Acts, chapter number 4. Acts chapter number 4. Join me if you would. I'm going to leave us the lion's share of this program's time today to dive into and introduce the concept of that which we will be sharing for these next few days and weeks. We're going to talk about how these discipleship studies factor into our outreach and our ministry a little bit more tomorrow as we go beyond the track for our normal Tuesday broadcast. But I'd like for you, if you would, join me in the book of Acts, chapter 4, and verse number 12. Here's what it says. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Here's the title, here's the thought, here's the theme of discipleship study number one. The thought is this: one word, salvation. Now, there are many biblical words that can be used for this concept, this idea of salvation. Words like justified, saved, received forgiveness, trusted Christ, converted, born again. They all mean the same thing. It doesn't really matter what you call it as long as it has happened to you. The word saved, that is a Bible word that is used much in Scripture. You just saw it in Acts chapter 4 and verse number 12. Another occasion of the word saved or salvation is Romans 10:10. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You in particular, my listener right now, need to get the entire picture of what salvation is if you are going to adequately deal with others about their souls. You will never do much for God until you realize how much He has done for you. But let's hit pause for just a moment. Here's my first question for you, our listener. Are you saved? Have you believed unto righteousness, as Romans 10:10, and with the mouth confessed unto salvation? Have you done that today? Well, before the conclusion of our broadcast, I'm going to walk you exactly through how you can know for sure today, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that if you died right now, that you would take your next steps into heaven. That word saved, salvaged, forgiven, spared, saved from sin and hell. What does that mean? Well, Acts 16:30, if you're curious about this idea of salvation and you've never experienced it for yourself, this one-time event, Acts 16:30 says, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" That's a lost man asking some Christians what he has to do to be saved. Ephesians 2:8-9 says, "For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast." You see, this idea of salvation is something that must occur in your life personally if you want to rightly anticipate spending eternity in heaven. The decision to follow after Christ, the decision for salvation, the decision for being born again into God's family cannot be made as a group. You see, friend, if I could force you and twist your arm to be saved, I would want to do that because I believe salvation is so good, everybody should experience it. But God has a different idea. You see, He gave us a free will. You can choose to reject Him or you can choose to accept Him. Now, what is this concept of salvation that you would be accepting? Well, let me break it down for you very quickly. We're not going to get very far into discipleship study number one because I think this bears mentioning. Number one, everyone is a sinner. If a man won't be honest, he cannot be helped. And so you and I must admit, before salvation is even on the table or worth discussing, we must admit that we have a problem. Number two, we must come to grips with the fact that there is a penalty for our sin. Just like if you go to work, let's just say for round numbers' sake, Let's say you make $10 an hour and you work 40 hours a week. Now, before Uncle Sam takes his cut, you should be getting somewhere in the ballpark of $400 a week. That is your rightful wage, your payment for what you did. Here's what the Bible says, though. For the wages, the payment of sin is death. And when the Bible says death, it's not just talking about the cessation of our heartbeat. It's not just talking about us not breathing anymore. It's talking about us passing from this life to the next. And there's only one of two places we can go. It's either heaven or it's hell. So just to review, number one, everyone is a sinner. Number two, there is a penalty for our wrongdoing, our unrighteousness, our sin. Number three, here's where the good news begins. Jesus Christ paid the penalty for you and for me. And lastly, this you've heard me mention already, we must accept that free gift. Did you know that you could accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior right now? You could do so if you'd like to. You could pray a simple prayer like this. Understand, before you pray with me, it's not the words. This is not some magic incantation. It's not some special mantra. It's not hocus pocus. This is the Bible telling us that for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You can accept Christ right now by praying a simple prayer like this and meaning it in your heart. Pray with me if you are interested. Dear God, I know that I'm a sinner. I know that the penalty for my sin is an eternity in hell. I want to accept your free gift of salvation. God, please save me and take me to heaven when I die. Amen. Did you just pray that prayer right now? Did you just get assurance of your salvation? Do you know for sure now, if you died right now and I asked you the question, where would you go? What would your answer be? Well, if you prayed that prayer and meant it, the Bible tells you that you would spend eternity in heaven. I would love to rejoice with you about that. Would you mind if you did make that decision? I'd love for you to join me tomorrow on the broadcast as we dive deeper into the idea of salvation, but I'd love for you to contact me. Text me right now, 309-316-7240. 309-316-7240. God bless.